I want to tell some stories too. So guys, I am the new Oprah here, boy style.
Open up, you OPN, bitch, you won't be BM.
Hey you, welcome back to my channel, you guys. We are here back in my kitchen because we're doing another story time, Daniel. So if you guys want to stick around and see what story I have to share with y'all, what kind of craziness I had got in when I was younger, then just stay tuned. Okay, so welcome back to my channel, you guys. Hopefully you guys seen my last video where I discussed what I've been watching during quarantine, what catch my eye. I just wanted to share with y'all what I like watching and things like that because we're trying to get to know me, right? So yeah, if you haven't seen it, go back and watch it and then come back and catch up. So we're here because it's Saturday, hopefully by the time I upload this. Story time again. Okay. I like was in a situation to where I thought I was going to jail. Like I thought that was it. That's the day I'm gonna get my first cuffs. That's the day I'm gonna get my first like mug shot. That's the first day that my mom's gonna be disappointed, my dad's gonna be disappointed, everybody gonna laugh at me about in the family. This is the moment. Like this is it. Like my life flashed before my eyes. But rewinding back, I became really, really good friends with this girl that I'm still Facebook friends with right now, but I'm not gonna use her name or nothing like that. So, we're speaking on fictional names here. So, I've decided to name my friend Carol Baskin, okay? Carol Baskin is my friend in this story, okay? So, when I say Carol Baskin, y'all know who I'm talking about. Okay, so I met Carol Baskin at a job that I worked at, like a telemarketing. It wasn't telemarketing. It was like a call center job. You know, a call center job. And I met her. Met Carol Baskin. We hit it off instantly and became really, 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 really good friends. Right? So much that I had my own apartment at the time. I was 18. Let's get that out of the way right now. I was 18, so this happened when I was still like young, you know, in my stupid thoughts and stuff like that. So let's put it out there right now that I was still just a child. That's all I'm saying. I had my own apartment though at the age of 18. Like I had already moved out, stuff like that. Me and her became so much good friends that I would just not even stay at my apartment. I would just spend the night with her. She had her own apartment, but she's older than me. Well, maybe by like a year or 2 years. But I would always be at her house. We just got real tight. But Carol Baskin used to steal. You know, she never pulled me along. Like we would barely even talk about it. Like this wasn't based around our friendship. You know, it's just something random. Like if she was to bring it up, because when she would do it, she wouldn't be with me. She'd be with her other friends, stuff like that. So we wouldn't really, really even talk about like her adventures of stealing stuff. That just, I just know that she did it. You know what I mean? That's just something, I don't. When they went to Walmart, and it's funny because I now live around the corner from that same Walmart. Literally every time like I have to see the Walmart that I buy, I really do think of this story. I mean, based on me and I was almost gonna say her real name. Ooh, I almost said her real name. Me and Carol Baskin and another woman and another girl, we would go in club and stuff like that. So we would go and get like our club outfit right before we would go out because we would work more than likely the same day. So we would go to the mall or whatever, get last minute outfits and then just go out. Keep in mind y'all, disclaimer, I've only been to a club 10 times out of my full life because I just hate them. Every single time I went to the club, I was dragged into it. So I'm not even, I ain't even gonna lie to you about that. Like, she came to club. I've literally only been 10 times in my life. So let's just get that shit out the way. This was one of those times. Now, I'm not sure if we have money or not, stuff like that, because the job we were working at the time were paying us like really good money to not work. Like, y'all, like we wouldn't call in, but we would get there, and there's this thing that is called like PTO or something like that, where you voluntarily leave from work, but sometimes like you'll still get paid and sometimes you won't. But they used to do that a lot of times at this job, like almost every day. So we would do that, but we would get paid so much like money still. So I'm not sure if we were just broke or just was just, she just wanted to just take our outfits. I don't know. So, long story short, because I'm not gonna make this long, we went to Walmart and she had with her like those little miniature backpack purses that you put on your back. She had one of those miniature purses that you put on your back, and we got inside of Walmart. And she literally, because first of all, she knew I was not down to steal, period. Like, don't fucking ever ask me, you know not to ask me type shit. If you want to do it, then that's on you. Like, I'm not joking. We could still be friends after this, but you, like, she knew not to fucking ask me to partake in the actual action of it. I will not do it. I'm not down to be the actual snatcher ever. So she knew to like not ask me to get myself involved in actually doing the action part. So we got into Walmart, and you guys, first of all, I didn't know she had planned to take anything. That's another thing, like, I don't be getting no heads up. We have to take a break now. I just need to remember where I was at. Oh yeah, I'm never down to steal. We hoping. Oh, you guys, you know what I just realized? I think Kylie Jenner has this dress, has a picture in this dress. And I'm not a Kardashian-y person. I'm not. Like, if I was, it'll be all over my social media. So don't be like, oh, another black girl talking about the Kardashians all the time. Everybody's so obsessed. I'm not obsessed. I just realized, because those are one of my favorite pictures on Fashion Nova, was when Kylie Jenner was wearing this dress. How did I do, though? How did I do though? How did I do in the dress? How the fuck did I do in this? Like, how did I do? Just gotta stop moving though, right? Hoo hoo hoo! So, basically everyone and their mama knew, like, I'm not gonna partake in, like, stealing anything from no flea market. I'm not that person. No, 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 no. I didn't like trouble. I didn't like trouble. So anyway, we get in Walmart. I'm trying to talk less with my hands, but it's so hard. Like, I'm a hander. Like, you know, I'm always doing this. I'm noticing when I'm watching my videos back that I'm always like, so I'm trying to just sit right here with them, but it's not really working because this whole video, see, I'm still talking. And she just lets me know, like, yo, I'm gonna like steal. I'm gonna steal. I'm gonna take some items. And I kind of looked at her backpack and like looked at her and rolled my eyes like, Heffa, you knew you was gonna steal this whole time. Cause I wouldn't have even went with her. That's another thing, like, don't ask me to steal with you and do not let me be with you on this trip. Like, you better let me know what you plan to do so I can say, no, I'm not going. So she caught me off guard twice. That's a no club. It wasn't no outfits, it was bras and panties. Like, she was saying she needed bras and panties. And she's gonna steal, so she asked me if I wanted anything. We were literally walking around y'all the section, and I was just pointing out the shit I wanted. Like, a lot of our fits, or a lot of our two pieces, we even matched. I remember walking around in the clothing section and just pointing out the shit I wanted and stuff like that. When she let me know she was about to start, I went in the grocery section. You know how Walmart has the grocery section and then it has like the other section? I went to the grocery section because the grocery section is literally like all the way down there. It's like I'm far away from the crime scene. That's where I wanted to be, far away from the crime scene, right? I actually purchased me some stuff. I purchased me some snacks. I have purchased Yes, you guys, my fan is like somewhere near. So if you hear that in the background, I apologize. I was gonna have my fan back. So we get to Walmart, she lets me know, yo, I'm about to steal, do you want anything? Hey, I actually purchased me some snacks. I purchased me some Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. Everybody knows this is my favorite. If you didn't know, now you know. Got me some Reese's Peanut Butter Cups. So much. I got me some Reese's. I got me just some snacks. I actually purchased my items. I went through the line and everything. I purchased my items. I received the receipt because I purchased my items. Like, I was appalled, y'all. So I purchased my items and I went outside. Y'all know how Walmart checks your stuff with the receipt, ABNC. I did all that. Got past the Walmart Security Society. I got past them because I had a receipt. I get outside and I was about to say her name again. Carol Baskin kind of like messaged me some kind of way. I don't know. Like I said, if it would be a text or did she actually call me, because cell phones wasn't a thing then. So I know damn sure she wasn't FaceTiming me and stuff like that. So she basically let me know, like, she told me to walk to the edge of Walmart. So y'all know, first of all, Walmart has a huge ass parking lot. So she asked me to walk to the edge of it, where it was like a neighborhood. So across from this Walmart were houses. So she told me to walk to the edge. It was houses and a bus stop. She told me to walk to the edge, right? I started walking to the edge with my bag, with my purchases. I had even memorized the face of my cashier, because that's important, it's coming up. I started walking to the edge of the Walmart because that's where we were gonna meet, because apparently she was already finished. Walking to the curb, here it comes. I'm literally at the curb now, almost off of like Walmart property. And here comes like this truck, the security truck, like hop, like swooping around me, like on some like hands in the air type shit, like, but it was like the security from Walmart, and they came and swooped in front of me with their lights on. They were like,
I'm sorry, but you can't leave like off of the premises.
Why the fuck not? Like, surely, obviously, right? No, ma'am, you can't. When I was 18, 17, high school-ish, I was kind of like a rebel. Like, I didn't do good with authority. Like, so, like, teachers told me shit. I was the one to talk back. I don't know why. Okay, that's not cute. Like that. So I was like that with that security. I was just kind of like, move, get the fuck out of my way. Like, I wasn't disrespectful. I wasn't saying all these things, but my actions were. So I just kind of like continued to try to walk around the truck. They swooped around me again. Like, man, we really can't let you leave the premises. I think they were like,
you have to wait here until the cops come.
So let me get this straight. I can't leave until the police come? The authorities. Why not? Like, what did I do? Basically, Carol Baskin got seen by somebody. I don't know if it was the security itself or like she had got caught. Apparently Carol Baskin had got caught up by someone. So someone seen it and had apparently reported that she was with someone, and the person like appointed me out. Like, all this shit happened so fast too. Like, it literally happened so fast. So the security was just like insisting I get in the security car and ride back all the way up to the front of Walmart, and I was like, nah, I'm good. Like, I walked. So I walked. She like, but the security, and it was a woman, she literally drove with me the whole time, y'all. Like, my 18, 19 year old rebel self was so fucking annoyed with that. Like, I just couldn't. Yeah, she just made sure like I wasn't going home, right? So we get back to the entrance and the police was already like there. So I was just like, damn, like they came really fast for this. Like, okay, you guys, this shit happened outside of Walmart. Like while people are going in and out, like I was out there with the police. I became that person that we usually slow down by to be nosy when we see that someone has stole a lot of the store. You know, I became that person. Oh my God. Oh, because everybody was going in and out, you know, seeing the officers speak to me. I'm holding a Walmart bag. So when I get to them, they just started asking me all this shit. They asked me like if I was stealing, and I was like, no, here's my receipt, here's my bag. Why would I have a whole Walmart's bag if I stole something? And then I was like pointing out the cashier person. I think they went and got the cashier person to confirm it, and like the cashier person remembered me because I had just paid for my stuff. So quickly I was able to clear my name, but they still wasn't having it. Like, they still weren't letting me go. Because why? Because they wanted my friend. Okay, please, you know they want you to become an informant. So yeah, they wanted my friend. They wanted me to give up like all the information and details. So they started asking me. They were just like, I just knew I was still gonna go down because I couldn't give them information. Like I still thought I was gonna be put in handcuffs. So they started asking me like, where's your friend? I was like what friend? Like I was in here by myself, A, B, and C. They were just like, no, you know, they seen your friend steal. She, you know, stole some items. Where's your friend type shit? Keep telling them like, I don't have a friend. If they see me speaking with someone, it was because I seen somebody that I knew, but we didn't come together. Like that's what I told them. We didn't come together, basically. Like I was like, I knew her, but we didn't come in here together. So I don't know where she's at. So I just was telling them like, sir, like, no, we didn't come in here together. I just knew her from school or some. I forgot what I was like necessarily saying, but I just let it be clear that we didn't come together. So then they kind of like started believing it or whatever. And then the scary part came. So they were just like, okay, we can't let you out of our sight until your ride comes and get you. Cause then they were asking me that too. Like, how'd you get here then? Like, who did you ride with? Realistically, I rode with Carol Baskin. That's another detail I forgot to say. We drove in her car. So technically I was shit out of luck because I'm like, oh my God, they're gonna see her when she picks me up from the curb. Like I have to fucking think quick. She was texting me during all this and she was just kind of like, you guys, like, I kid you not, she said she was watching us the whole scene. And I was like, where are you watching us from? And she was like, I'm down, like, it was a strip and she was like two stores down, but looking like directly at us on some movie shit, like a stakeout type of shit. She was watching the officers like question me from her car. And so I had looked down and I seen her just sitting in her car, but the officers don't know that's her car and shit like that. So I'm just like, now that I'm thinking about it, it's funny because I'm like, this is so dramatic. Like, this is fucking dramatic. She's just sitting down there letting me, like, have to go through this. But she was frightened because they was gonna get her. I'm sitting down here, come walk down here. And I was like, they're not letting me go, bro. Like, they're not letting me go. I cannot just walk down there. Like, they're not letting me fucking go. So what now? My brother lived in that area. He's 8 years older than me. And I took a chance with even hitting him up because my brother don't like the police, you know, just thought he wasn't just gonna come. He just wasn't gonna come because hell no, I'm not gonna go there and the cops is just sitting right there. Hell no, like I just knew it for sure. But my brother came through, so I just thought quick and I started texting my brother because I didn't want the officer to kind of like hear me talking to him because I told the officer a lie. Because the officer was asking me who was going to pick me up. I immediately said my brother, like I lied to him immediately. So I had to get my brother on, basically. So I was just like, my man. That's my brother's nickname anyway. We call him man. So it's extra funny to me because, yeah. Anyway. I was like, I'm here, you know, at Walmart with Carol Baskin. And she stole some stuff and the police, like, are not letting me go until my ride. And I was like, I told the police that it was you because if she pulls up, they're going to, like, try to handcuff her. My brother was down. Like I said, it was just a total shock. That was like the longest wait in life, in fucking life. I'm sitting here waiting with the cops outside of Walmart, just looking like a real fucking juvenile. But then, you guys know what happened. An angel came down. So basically it turns out I could have waited for Carol Baskin instead of hitting up my brother but I didn't know this part was gonna happen. So what ended up happening is the officers kind of left me there after a while because I guess the officers were just like, okay, we got other shit we need to be doing, you know, we need to go patrol these roads, like we could be doing, y'all know how police are, we could be doing other shit than just sitting here with a 19-year-old girl waiting for her ride. You know, clearly she didn't steal anything. Like I said, I showed them my receipts, like I was in the clear. So I guess they seen it as like, this is a waste of time, so they decided to leave me because they trusted me. She's not a criminal. She's really not a criminal. They ended up leaving before my brother got there because they were just kind of like, okay, take care, ma'am. Like, we gotta go do other shit. We gotta go, I don't know. We gotta go bust somebody. I don't know. We gotta go pick up the mafia or something. They just got better things to do. So we ended up getting home to her place, y'all, and just discussed it. Like, I gave her my view. Basically, I gave her the story I just gave y'all. With the police and what they were asking me. Oh, another detail I left out, y'all. When I was talking to the police, I was kind of shitting Brits though, because at that time I had a speeding ticket that I hadn't paid for yet. And I thought I had a warrant out. So I gave the police my wrong date of birth. Caught up on that because the officer couldn't find me, and I was just like, I'm sorry, my birthday is this, this, and that. He was kind of like, why did you lie? Just kind of like, why did you lie? That's embarrassing. It was just like, man, listen, like, I'm not the one to get involved with police, so I'm not gonna lie. I don't feel comfortable lying, because in my eyes, they're gonna know that I'm lying, and I'm gonna get more in trouble for doing it. I told that little white lie of the year. I just changed the year I was born. He was just kind of like, why did you lie? And I was just like, because, you know, I thought I had an active warrant out for a speeding ticket. And he was just like, no, you don't. Like, your name's not even pulling up in anything. Like, and I'm just like thinking in my head, like, shut the fuck up. You're telling on yourself. Like, I can see. But yeah, I forgot I left that part out. To her place, I told her like my story of it, and we exchanged everything. But we got to the good part. We went in her backpack, and she pulled out all the cute little bra and panties we had. So we had like matching fits. So we told Star we were the shit, because we were really fucking good friends, y'all. So this was exciting for us. Like, she pulled them out, and I was just like, oh, we're gonna be cute and fast. Like, hey. But yeah, that is it, you guys. That's a crazy story. Like, I don't know. I think that story was worth telling, because I don't have any friends, and no one's ever really heard that story aside from me and the person that actually lived through it, and my brother. Unless she told some people about it, but I don't think she did. So me and Carol Baskin was almost in handcuffs, and y'all would have been able to look up TheeMimiDeshun and see a mugshot, honey. And that wouldn't have been too cute. Mm-mm. No, ma'am, no ham, no slice, no dice. Guys, I hope you enjoyed that little story. I hope you guys had your little drink on. I hope you guys are enjoying the content that I'm bringing to you guys. I hope you guys are enjoying. I hope you guys are enjoying the consistency. And meet me back here in my kitchen next Saturday for another story. I have plenty. If someone was having a bad day, maybe it made you smile. I hope you guys enjoyed my story. Like I said, once again, this dress is from Fashion Nova. It don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to With Gem, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.